Institute was established in 1998, and the founders had only empty building to start with and less than €500,000. And now in 20 years that we are celebrating recently, we now have above 200 employees. The Institute managed to publish more than 800 publications. Our budget for last year was above €11 million, and over a course of many years we were always ranked as one of the top Polish institute for life sciences by the Ministry of Higher Education. So you may ask what makes us a good place to work, what makes us unique. So first of all, we were the first in Poland to have so-called international advisory board. That's a unique group of scientists who are very prominent and successful scientists, and they are coming from all over the world, who not only give us some precious advice how to really go towards organizational and scientific excellence in the Institute, but also they are those people who are responsible for selecting of group leaders and very importantly for evaluating the group leaders regularly every 3 years. And not only group leaders, but also all our scientists are selected, are recruited in open competition procedure, which is always open, transparent and merit-based. And this is ensured by the HR Excellence in Research logo that we got in 2013. And all the scientists who are employed are actually on temporary contracts that favors mobility. And research in the Institute is mostly based on grants. And what me and I would say most of my colleagues also value the most is that we really have team spirit in the Institute. There is a flat structure. The junior, the PIs have a lot of research freedom, and many decisions in the Institute are also done collectively and in dialogue with all the staff. Or I mean, really, we have a feeling that all of us, not only scientists, but all our staff, we are having a common goal, which is achieving best and most exciting research results. For the funding, I mean, we were quite successful over the years to get very competitive grants. I mean, some of them are like ERC grants, RECPO grants from Wellcome Trust, EMBO installation grants, and I'm also quite proud of my colleagues because this year we managed to have this very nice grant that we called MOSAIC, which stands for Molecular Signaling in Health and Disease Interdisciplinary Center of Excellence, and this is the H 2020 program in IRA chair scheme. And this grant is now for 5 years with quite good funding, and we will implement a lot of changes towards scientific and organizational excellence of the Institute, including employment of a middle stage excellent scientist as a group leader now. So we hope to grow and we hope to be even better. And I have to say that we were the only one institute in Poland to receive this grant among 13 other laureates in Europe. So it was a big achievement and we are looking forward to what this will bring us now. So of course the Institute is the heart of the Institute are our laboratories. Currently we have 9 groups in Warsaw and 2 other groups that are affiliated with us, one in Germany run by Michael Potente working on angiogenesis, and the second one in Poznań working on biomolecular interactions run by head by Jan Brzozowski. And our PIs, I mean, I'm not speaking about me, definitely, but about my colleagues, they are not only very good scientists, but they are also very actively involved in science policy making. So they act as advisors to European Commission, to Ministry of Higher Education, to also the granting agencies like NCN. They are panelists, for example, in ERC. 2 of them were selected EMBO members, and 4 others are also the members of Polish Academy of Sciences. And Well, from the research topics, and I realize it will be mostly interesting maybe for life scientists who are in audience, that maybe you get interested in some of my colleagues' research, or mine maybe. So very brief introduction, what are the most current, let's say, research teams in each of the laboratory. So Matthias Bochtler, who is mostly structural biologist and biochemist, is currently interested in understanding how DNA reprogramming co-opts DNA repair and how this may happen vice versa. Jacek Kuźnicki works on the calcium homeostasis and calcium signaling in different neurodegenerative disorders, and he's using zebrafish and mouse models for his research. Cecilia Vinata, she is our zebrafish expert and also very much interested into the heart. So she tries to elucidate the gene regulatory networks that underlies both heart development and heart functions. And also her side interest is into post-transcriptional regulation of maternal mRNA in zebrafish development. Janusz Bujnicki, he is our chief bioinformatician, and currently he tries to combine RNA crystallography with computational modeling. He is very much interested in a structure-based design of new molecules and in RNA modifications and impacts of this modification on RNA structure and function. Marta Miocińska, an expert in cell biology mostly, she is studying now molecular communication between the organelles that are involved in endocytosis and how this crosstalks to signal transduction. And also she looks for cellular consequences of endosomal dysfunction for proteostasis or metabolism or cancer. In my laboratory, we are mostly, for one of the projects, we are looking for cell-to-cell communication in the liver to find new mechanisms of iron sensing of iron into in our body. We are also very much interested in iron homeostasis mechanism in very specialized cell types. And we are also trying to find new ways of regulation of some of the iron regulatory genes to basically learn what kind of new processes can also affect body iron levels. Jacek Jaworski, he focuses on molecular and cellular basis of neuronal development and brain functions and how this contributes to stress-related disorders. Marcin Nowotny, in the field of structural biology, he performs studies of enzymes that are involved in the processing of genetic information and specifically looking at DNA repair, reverse transcription of RNA processing. And finally, last but not the least, Wojtek Pokrzywa, he is our aging and proteostasis expert, and he now looks for signals that coordinate the function of distinct E3 ubiquitin ligases. He looks for stress-induced myosin folding and regulation of epigenetic memory by the ubiquitin and proteasome system. So if you are interested in any of these topics, please come to me or contact my colleagues directly. So all our research, apart from the research that is in the main laboratories, we have also other initiatives and other projects in the institute. One of such projects is ProBioStructure. This is a kind of spin-off company that provides structural biology service for both academia and industry. And here they are also involved in drug design. And they provide a service from DNA constructs towards the structure of the protein at the end. And another project that is very interesting is Aurizin project run by Isa Sabawa. And here they are using bacteriolytic enzymes to fight Staphylococcus aureus. And all this research wouldn't be possible without great core facilities and staff who works there that are providing cutting-edge methodologies and equipment for our research. And altogether, our all scientific work wouldn't be possible without really great administrative staff that we very appreciate, especially what is important for us scientists, it's our grants office who supports us in every phase of grants application towards grant reporting. And one person also from administration unit who is our expert in PR, Daria Gosz, is here with me in Oxford. So if you have any questions, please come to me or to Daria, and we are happy to answer. At the end, I would like to emphasize that we really appreciate our international environment in the Institute. I already mentioned our advisory board, who are all foreigners, or I mean, some of them are Polish, but all of them almost are working abroad. Among our PIs, we have this three foreigners, so around one third of us is from abroad. This also refers to our postdocs and PhD students. Over the years, we had four joint groups with Max Planck Society, and truly, English is our official language in the Institute, both for staff, for our administrative colleagues, and for all the seminars and so on and so forth. So I would be really happy if you get interested, and we are constantly looking for good people. So join us if you find our research interesting for your interests. And I also have to mention that we are, of course, not the only nice institute in Poland. There are several others right now that are also following some of the aspects which I told you about. So I think it's a lot of things are changing in Poland over years, and I'm really looking forward to what this will bring for all of us. So thank you for your attention.